to the Princeton High School Spring Band Concert, known as our Ice Cream Social. Be sure to visit Granny's Goodies on the Go outside of Viking Village, and a portion of the proceeds will go back to the Princeton Music Boosters. And I believe the weather cleared up just in time for Granny's Goodies on the Go. We'd like to take a moment to recognize any administrators, board members, or other Princeton staff in the audience and thank them for coming. Please stand and be recognized. Are there any Princeton alum in the house? Please stand and recognize. Any graduates of Princeton? We'd also like to thank our auditorium manager, Mr. Jason Hollowell, for our light and sound tonight. I think he's in the back. Thank you, Jason. Please note that there are four exits in our auditorium out the back, left and right, both downstairs and in the balcony. Please keep the two aisleways clear, as those are for performers to enter and exit the stage. Restrooms are located by the arena, but we request that you only enter and exit Matthews during applause or stage changes. Please help us keep our auditorium nice by keeping all food and drink in the lobby only. Out of respect for our performers, please refrain from all cell phone use, unless you are capturing photo memories, in which case, please turn off the flash. We'd also like to thank the Princeton Music Boosters for everything they do to support music at Princeton with fundraising, advocacy, scholarships, and especially creating our printed program. Please use the program insert, I believe there's one in there, to become a Music Booster member. All right, without further ado, please welcome to the stage Mr. Lenhart and Mr. Phillips and the Scarlet and Gray Bands.
Good Thank you very much. That piece was entitled Sparks by Brian Balmages and was a lot of fun to put together and perform. Please welcome to the stage my colleague, Mr. Todd Lenhardt, director of Scarlet Band. And he's going to conduct for us a selection of music from the movie musical West Side Story.
Thank you.
do a quick stage change to get ready for symphonic band. Parents of seniors in Scarlet Band will need to stick around because we're going to do our senior recognition after symphonic band's performance. So seniors in Scarlet, we'd like to have you backstage during symphonic band's third song to get ready for your senior recognition. Thank you for your patience.
right, thank you for your patience while we reset the stage. The First Symphonic Band Beast tonight features the music of Danny Elfman. Please help me welcome to the stage my student teacher, Ms. Shepherd, to conduct Music for a Darkened Theater.
Thank you.
for Lindsay was commissioned by Jack Stamp at Indiana University of Pennsylvania. It is an expansion on a short and unnamed piano piece that Boyson, the composer, wrote for his wife Lindsay in 2005. The wind piece is larger in length and scope than the source material. In the score, Boyson describes it as a very personal work, more than anything else, a simple long love song dedicated to Lindsay and what she has meant in my life. The piano piece is used as a starting point, and the material in the winds is either based on or a direct quotation of it. Lyrical in nature and just over 5 minutes long, solo horn and solo flute are prominent throughout. The scoring is deliberately and symbolically used because Boyson plays the horn, the composer, and his wife plays the flute. Song for Lindsay has been described as interesting, serious, and distinctive music by members of the World Association of Symphonic Bands and Ensembles. It has been a challenging and mature piece of music for a symphonic band to work on, and we hope you enjoy Song for Lindsay.
Thank you.
Okay, before our last number, I will recognize Princeton Music Booster Private Lesson Scholarship recipients for 22-23. As soon as I find them. There they are. All right, when I call your name, you're going to come up across the front of the stage and you're all going to stand there so we can take a picture. First up, the Princeton Music Booster George Parsley Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Wesley Englin for horn lessons for the 22-23 school year. If you can find your way through.
Yeah.
So there you go. And go walk across over there. Yep. All right, and the Princeton Music Boosters Johnny L. Williams Memorial Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Zach Burns for trumpet lessons for the 22-23 school year. All right, you guys, I need a pathway through here. Shake hands, take that, go stand over there. Princeton Music Boosters Larry Meraz Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Cole Spradlin for clarinet lessons for the 22-23 school year. The Princeton Music Boosters Sam Reynolds Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Nicholas Brandt for trumpet lessons for the 22-23 school year. The Princeton Music Boosters David Kirkendall Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Gemley Ambrosio Perez for horn lessons for 22-23 school year. And the Princeton Music Boosters David J. Maroon Private Lesson Scholarship is awarded to Jose Cruz for trumpet lessons for the 22-23 school year. Thank you. Congratulations. And then I need somebody down there to take a picture of them for me. Who's got it? Who's got the camera? Who's taking a picture for me? Thank you, Mr. Burton. Stay there, smile. Great. Okay, you guys can go back to your seats. Thank you. All right. Symphonic Band will wrap up our performance year with a saxophone feature called Five to Go. Upon the conclusion of this piece, seniors will line up backstage to begin senior recognition. And if we could have, yep, you know, the nine stands and saxophones stand up and come get organized. I need to remind all the senior parents and the seniors that their school-issued uniforms are due tonight. They were instructed to bring other clothes to change into, so we are collecting their tuxedos and their performance dresses. Tonight, if for some reason they can't turn that in tonight, we'll need it back tomorrow. A few of them still need it for the choir concert, so they will turn it in at the conclusion of the choir concert. And I also want to thank Mr. Fermier. He's going to be playing electric bass on this final piece. And after this piece, we will start all of our senior recognition. So without further ado, we will get organized and play Five to Go. Okay, and this is awkward but necessary, but now I'm going to have the entire symphonic band stand and be recognized for their all three pieces of their concert. All right, seniors, you're going to set your things down and head backstage. Everyone else is going to have a seat. Right, we are ready for senior recognition. First, I'm going to talk about Tri-M, but they're not going to come out. I'm just going to announce Tri-M, and then you'll hand the cords out when I announce them. The Tri-M Music Honor Society is the International Music Honor Society for high school students. It is designed to recognize students for their academic and musical achievements, reward them for their accomplishments and service activities, and to inspire other students to excel at music and leadership. Tonight we will honor our senior members with the Tri-M graduation cord, which they will wear at graduation. The silk cord in pink is the academic color for music. So as I call them across the stage, I will also let you know if they are getting a Tri-M cord. So, our class of 2022. This was the first group to go all the way grade 6 through 12 in the new building. Yep. These seniors have been through band remote learning, band hybrid learning, band masks, and band bell covers. Basically, whatever it took to keep making music, keep performing, continue traditions, and rigor. Many of these students were on the Disney trip in February of 2020. An infamous date, right? This group of seniors learned how to keep going, keep trying, and keep achieving. They are the class of problem solvers. No matter what life has thrown at them during high school, they figured it out and continued to practice, perform, and achieve. They've possibly had the most difficult high school experience in our teaching careers, yet they've exceeded all expectations and are graduating with a unique skill set that will see them through everything that the future holds. We have no doubt that they will go forth into college, career, and life with success, and we hope they come back to visit and share their accomplishments with us. And remember, once a Viking, always a Viking. Hopefully they're listening backstage. All right, so without further ado, first up is Pierre-Marie Amagadze, son of Afi Kumi. He was in symphonic band and cadet band. He's attending either the University of Cincinnati or Xavier and majoring in pre-medicine. His favorite band memory, the Disney trip, sophomore year, Pierre. Yael Aparicio, and Yael will be receiving a Tri-M cord. He is the son of Uriel Aparicio and Abdulia Alvarado Santana. He was in symphonic band, jazz ensemble, marching band, solo and ensemble contest, and large group contest. He is attending The Ohio State University and plans to study construction systems management. His favorite band memory is partnering, in quotes, partnering Henry and us with the Argentinians. I should have checked into that story a little bit more. But anyway, Yael. Jamie Bartolone. Jamie gets a Tri-M cord. She is the daughter of Dario Bartolone and Betty Perez. She was in symphonic band, pit orchestra, solo and ensemble contest, large group contest. She is attending the University of Dayton to major in biology, with a focus on pre-dental. Her favorite band memory is sitting next to Michaela, Jamie Bartolone. McKenna Bullock is the daughter of Jess Fuchs of Sharonville. She's in a cappella choir, marching and concert bands, volleyball, key club, student council, church youth group, recreational volleyball. She's planning to attend the University of Cincinnati Blue Ash campus, majoring in pre-social work. Her favorite band memory is going to Disney World and performing on Main Street. McKenna Bullock. Tommy Burton. Tommy gets a tri-M chord. He is the son of Tom Burton and Franca Burton. He's in symphonic band, jazz ensemble, marching band, solo and ensemble contest, large group contest. He's attending The Ohio State University to study finance. His favorite band memory was going to Memphis and being on Beale Street for 6 hours every day. Tommy Burton. Molly Cannon. Molly gets a tri-M chord. She is the daughter of Joanne and Sean Cannon. She is in symphonic band, marching band, pit orchestra, solo and ensemble contest, and large group contest. She is attending Heidelberg University to study environmental science with a focus in water quality. Her favorite band memory was marching in Disney World with the marching band, Molly Cannon. Brett Doss. Brett gets a tri-M chord. He is the son of Dean and Krista Doss. He's in a cappella choir, vocal chamber ensemble, Viking Voices Men's Choir, jazz lab, jazz ensemble, symphonic band, marching band, spring musicals, all of them, most of them, and attending the University of Cincinnati, majoring in exploratory studies. His favorite band memory is playing his trumpet at 7:10 every day. Brett Doss. Abigail Emery. Abigail gets a tri-M chord. She is the daughter of John and Rhonda Emery. She's in symphonic band, jazz lab, marching band, spring musical, solo and ensemble contest, large group contest, and the OMEA honor band. She's attending the University of Cincinnati to study engineering. Her favorite band memory, music inventory, when we get to play random instruments to see if they work and visit the trumpet graveyard. Abigail Emery. Abigail, you're welcome back every summer to help me with that. Jerrica Fitzgerald. Jerrica gets a tri-M chord. She is the daughter of Pam and Daryl Fitzgerald of Woodlawn. She's in a cappella choir, band, student council, key club, NHS, Spanish, National Honor Society, tri-M, cheer, lacrosse, all kinds of things. She's attending Delaware State, majoring in forensics and IT. Her favorite band memory is going to Disney World and getting lost. Jerrica Fitzgerald. Mary Kimball. Mary Kimball is getting a tri-M chord. And stay right here, Mary. I'm gonna give you this chair. Mary is also getting a tri-M recognition of excellence, which is an extra tri-M recognition. Now you can keep going. She is in symphonic band, jazz ensemble, marching band, spring musical, solo and ensemble contest, large group contest, Cy Wee Wind Ensemble, which she had last night was her final concert there, CSYO Philharmonic Orchestra. She attended the Interlochen Philharmonic Orchestra camp. She was in all-state orchestra. OMEA Honor Band and Honor Jazz. She will be attending the Eastman School of Music to major in French horn performance. Her favorite band memory, performing at football games with the marching band, Mary Kimball. Jacob Kinney. Jacob is getting a tri-M chord. He is the son of Janet and Kevin Kinney. He is in symphonic band, jazz ensemble, marching band, and solo and ensemble contest. He will be attending Eastern Kentucky University for forensic chemistry and will be a member of the Marching Colonels. His favorite band memory, the countless hours on Beale Street in Memphis, getting to spend time with friends and visit shopping areas, Jacob Kinney. Carter Logston. Carter is getting a Tri-M chord. He is the son of Kathy and Josh Logston of Sharonville. He's in a cappella choir, vocal chamber ensemble, Viking Voices Men's. He was drum major. He's in jazz ensemble, symphonic band, 12 theater shows, NHS secretary, OMEA honor jazz band. He will be attending the University of Cincinnati, majoring in, and this is no surprise to any of us, communications. His favorite band memory, performing with the jazz band in Memphis on the last night of the trip, Carter Logston. Amaya McNulty. Amaya is the daughter of Jessica Schifferl of Springdale. She's an a cappella choir, marching band, and scarlet band. She is attending the University of Cincinnati, majoring in nursing. Her favorite band memory, going to Florida and marching with the Pride of Princeton at Disney World on Valentine's Day, Amaya McNulty. Kobe Mensah. Kobe is the son of Margaret Mensah. He was in Scarlet Band and Marching Band. He is going to Undecided University to study psychology and computer science. His favorite band memory, senior band night during marching band season, playing while the fireworks were going off, Kobe Mensah. Dia Patel. Dia is the daughter of Nimisabin and Hitesh Patel. She is in Scarlet Band and Cadet Band. She is attending the University of Cincinnati Medical Science or Wake Forest University. Did you decide? Which one are you going to? Oh, still deciding. Just two different choices. Okay. Well, wherever she goes, she's planning to do biology pre-med. And her favorite band memory was Disney. Dia Patel. Charles Pels. Charles is the son of Jim and Lisa Pels. He's in Scarlet Band and Marching Band. He's attending the University of Cincinnati Blue Ash to study information technology. His favorite band memory, the Disney trip we did his sophomore year, Charles Pels. Ruben Ramirez. Ruben is the son of Maria and Aaron Ramirez. He is in Scarlet Band and Marching Band. He will be attending trade school for high performance motorsports, then find a job in either NASCAR, IndyCar, or the NHRA. We're gonna watch him on TV someday, I think. His favorite band memory, Blink. And that was Ruben Ramirez. Brandon Rendring. Brandon is getting a Tri-M chord, and he is getting the Tri-M recognition of excellence. He is the son of Alan and Becky Rendering of Sharonville. He's in, well, he lists everything here, but actually Brandon, like, never left the department this school year. So, like, all seven bells of his day was in the music department. He was in a cappella choir, vocal chamber ensemble, jazz ensemble, symphonic band, jazz combo. He was Albert Peterson in the musical. What else is on here? He's an Eagle Scout, and his Eagle project was plume boxes for the marching band, and also for, he built a podium for the pit orchestra down here. So those were his Eagle Scout project. And he was in CyWee, he was in the Cincinnati Greater Youth Jazz Collaborative. He will be attending Miami University, majoring in music education and music composition. His favorite band memory is performing in front of an unsuspecting live audience at a in Memphis with the jazz band, Brandon Rendering. I know, right? Elijah Spence. Elijah is the son of Paul and Monica Spence of Forest Park. He was in a cappella choir, marching band, water polo, swim team, and tennis. Elijah is undecided on plans after high school. His favorite band memory was the marching band trip to Disney World. Elijah Spence. Ian Stanger. Ian is the son of Betty Stanger and Kenny Stanger. He's in symphonic band, jazz ensemble, marching band, solo ensemble contest, and large group contest. He is attending the University of Cincinnati pre-med program. His favorite band memory, traveling to Disney with the marching band, Ian Stanger. Taj Stewart. Taj is the son of David Stewart and Angela Stewart. He was in Scarlet Band and Marching Band. He's attending the University of Cincinnati studying plant science, and his favorite band memory, playing the music in Disney World, Taj Stewart. Hannah Vagley, and Hannah gets a triumph court. She's the daughter of Carly Prather and Gary Vagley of Sharonville. She's an a cappella choir, choraliers, scarlet singers, symphonic band, concert band, Triumph Music Honor Society, National Honor Society, soccer, lacrosse, all kinds of things. And she is attending The Ohio State University, majoring in biology, and her favorite band memory was the Disney trip, Hannah Vagley. All right, last but certainly not least, we have Zakiya Yasharel, son of Leanne Williams. He's in Scarlet Band and Marching Band. His future plans, he doesn't know yet, but he wants to go to racing college or a NASCAR college. His favorite band memory was the Disney trip by a long shot, meeting his girlfriend and making unforgettable memories. It's by far the greatest experience he's ever had, Zakiya. All right, so we're gonna pull this long line of seniors back out of the dark. So Zakiya, you're gonna lead the line in front of the podium. Everybody on here on the line here. Yep, and we'll space out. You're gonna stop right there so that we can get good pictures and a few more recognitions. There we go, everybody fits now. All right. Next up is the Joanne Meyer College Music Major Scholarship. Joanne Meyer was the first district music coordinator for the Princeton School District, a position she held for 35 years. From the formation of the district until her retirement in 1995, Mrs. Meyer was the unquestioned leader and driving force behind the Princeton Music Program. Under her guidance, Princeton achieved state and national recognition for the breadth and depth of its music program. Her leadership extended to all areas of the music curriculum, and the comprehensive excellence of the K-12 music program was among her proudest accomplishments. Following her sudden and tragic death shortly after her retirement, the Princeton Music Boosters established a fund for an annual private lesson scholarship in her name. In seeking to assure that her name and contributions are memorialized indefinitely, it is now felt that this award should be used to support and encourage students pursuing a career in music. Beginning in 2010, Princeton seniors who are entering college as music majors may apply for the scholarship. This is intended to be a one-time award. Only Princeton High School seniors who have declared music as their major course of study at an accredited college or university may apply. This year, the Princeton Music Boosters will be awarding two of these scholarships. So one Princeton Music Boosters, Joanne Meyer, $1,000 music scholarship is awarded to Mary Kimball to be applied to the pursuit of a major in music performance at the Eastman School of Music. And the second Princeton Music Boosters, Joanne Meyer, $1,000 music scholarship is awarded to Brandon Rendering to be applied to the pursuit of a major in music education and composition at Miami University. All right, we're almost done. All right. By the way, one thing that they were all handed in this envelope was the, do I have one in here? No. It is the music senior yearbook. So that's what they have in the envelope that everybody received. All right, we are ready for the John Philip Sousa Band Award. Since its inauguration in 1954, thousands of U.S. high schools have presented the John Philip Sousa Band Award to their most outstanding band student. The award recognizes a young musician displaying superior musicianship, leadership, dependability, loyalty, cooperation, and other qualities of conduct which school instrumental music programs strive to impart. The Sousa Award is the top nationwide prize in the school band field, both in prestige and appearance. It promotes the entire band by encouraging musicians to greater achievement and enthusiasm while providing an inspiring stimulus for potential instrumentalists. It is fitting that this award should be inspired by the name of John Philip Sousa, the premier American bandsman who was elected in 1973 to the Hall of Fame for Great Americans. No other composer is so well known to band students, and Sousa was one of the most renowned supporters of school music programs. He appeared as a great conductor of school bands throughout the U.S. and served as an adjudicator of numerous youth band festivals. This award is voted on by band students and confirmed by the band staff. And each year, we have more and more really wonderful candidates. So it's really hard because only one. So that's why we rely on the students to vote, and then the directors confirm with them. And typically, we agree with their choice, as we did again this year. But like there are so many outstanding candidates, it's always hard. But this year, the John Philip Sousa Award, and whomever I say is going to get this little desk weight, that's what it's called. And they get their name on this plaque that lives in infamy in the band room. And they get a certificate, an official certificate that is signed by all of the band staff. And so this year's John Philip Sousa Band Award goes to Mary Kimball. You get this, and this, and you get to take pictures with this, but I need the plaque back. Okay, so you can take that with you. All right. And step on up, we'll get last chance for pictures. One more round of applause for all of our wonderful seniors. This concludes our concert and senior recognition. Thank you all for being a part of our final high school band concert and being a part of our music family. Be sure to visit Granny's Goodies on the go and drive safely. Thank you.